Also making headlines this evening, the forensic audit report of the central bank bond scam that has been tabled in Parliament revealed potential conflict of interest of Arjuna Mahendran, the then governor of the central bank, who was alleged to have headed the monetary authority during the controversial bond scam.
The forensic audit, which comprises of 5 volumes, has been presented without the annexes and exhibits. Forensic audit report says during the review, 4 instances were noted where Kasun Palisena, the CEO of PTL, who is on bail, had shared confidential information to the official email ID of Arjuna Mahendran, governor at cbsl.lk. Following the controversial bond scams that took place in 2015 and 2016, an email that was sent by Kasun Palisena has been noted in the report. It reads, an email of 4th April 2016 at 1721 was noted wherein Kasun Palisena wrote to Arjuna Mahendran that all transactions are settled and cleared. He also apologized for some difficulties caused for Arjuna Mahendran because of him. Unquote. The report also identifies an abnormal success rate of 96% for Perpetual Treasuries Limited, and verbiage mentioned in the email indicates that Arjuna Mahendran potentially shared some unpublished price-sensitive information with Kasun Palisena of PTL, and he acknowledged the assistance of Arjuna Mahendran with a subject email. The said email communications between Arjuna Mahendran and Kasun Palisena indicated that Arjuna Mahendran was in regular touch with key managerial personnel of PTL for matters not related to the Central Bank of Sri Lanka. Meanwhile, the forensic audit also points out possible conflict of interest during Ajit Nivad Kabral's time at the central bank during the Mahinda Rajapaksa regime, as Kabral's family members were directors of primary dealer companies as well as banks under the supervision of the Central Bank of Sri Lanka. It notes Siromi Noel Wickremasinghe, sister of Ajit Nivad Kabral, was associated with the holding company of PTL, Perpetual Capital Holdings Private Limited, as a director from 23rd December 2013 until 9th March 2015. It was noted that Siromi Noel Wickremasinghe was sharing key managerial positions at the holding company of PTL and previous organization, along with Arjun Aloysius. In addition, the report says Shibani Renuka Thambaya, niece of Ajit Nibad Kabral, associated with Renuka Group, where PTL had invested, and during public domain search, as per the media article dated 19th March 2017 in the Sunday Times, Perpetual Asset Management Private Limited, which is the immediate holding company of Perpetual Treasuries Limited, made substantial investments in Renuka Group of Companies, in which Ajit Nivad Kabral had close family connections. More details to follow.
So then, apita CD 30 eka labadunna eka api stutiwanta wenawa namuth sampurna vaarthawa meke nahalu
godak welawata apita peena aakarayata
Nobody wants to stop this. We want to release this as well. So this is up to the speaker. So tell the speaker to release it completely. Deputy Speaker, Parliamentarian Ranjan Ramanayake mentioned yesterday that Arjun Aloysius contacted him, but the Bond Commission didn't state anywhere that Arjun Aloysius was in contact with an MP who was part of the COP. The report mentioned about other MPs who made 10 to 20 phone calls, so it is suspicious if the investigation was carried out properly. There should be 5 reports from 2002 to 2015. The copies of the reports are available in the Parliament and the Central Bank. But if the CD does not contain all of this information, an investigation should be carried out as to why it is incomplete. There are only 6 days left. We have the debate to obtain these almost every day. We will not even be able to debate these reports in Parliament. Our expectation was to have the debate tomorrow and the day after. That has also not been done. It is clear now that these transactions took place via the Employees' Provident Fund. So what is the loss incurred by the Central Bank? What about the Treasury's loss? The gamble took place via the EPF. A debate should be held immediately.